Bible, friends, is perhaps a book you've never really considered, you know, seriously, but don't you know it's the only revelation that we have from God? It's the only source of knowledge that's available to you in order that you might come to a right knowledge of God, the true and living God. That is the God who gave you the Bible in order that you, that you might have eternal life through His Son, Jesus Christ. You see, there is no other reliable source. You know, Bible's indictment, God's indictment is that all men are liars. So, you know, you turn to any other source, it matters not what it is. You know, the Church of Rome, to Mecca, with its Quran, the Watchtower Society, with its publications. You see, all men are liars, God says. So the only source, you see, of truth, the only reliable source that you have is the Word of God itself. What God says, not even what I say to you, but what God says. That's the only word, that's the only source that's reliable and that's trustworthy. So I offer you a copy of the part of the Bible, the New Testament. It's offered to you free of charge and without any cost or any obligation to you. Yours to take and do with you as you will, but if you read it, study it, meditate upon what God has to say about Himself, about yourself, and of course, importantly, about His Son, Jesus Christ, whom He sent into the world, not so that you would be religious, but so that you would be saved, so that you would be rescued. The gospel, friends, the good news concerning God's Son, Jesus Christ, a person, not a religion. You've already got a world full of religion. It's everywhere. It's all over you like a rash, you know? But does it make the world any better, any safer, any kinder, any more wholesome? The very opposite's the truth, because religion just doesn't cut it. Religion doesn't save people. It doesn't bring the life of God into their souls. It doesn't transform them, change them morally, spiritually, or any which way. Only the gospel, only the good news concerning God's Son, Jesus Christ, can do that. It's the power of God. It's still the power of God for salvation. Not religion, salvation that you need. And that's to be found in Jesus. That's to be found in the one I declare to you here in Walsall this afternoon. So you'd like to have a copy. You'd like to have a copy of the New Testament. It's yours for the taking, free, no charge, no obligations to you, none whatsoever. You'd like one. Well, you come and ask for one. Bible, of course, you know, people are always asking me. I go to these towns and cities, and they ask me for directions to, you know, certain places. I was in the Bullring the other week, and a woman asked me where the bus station was. I said, I'm a stranger here. I can't tell you. Can't tell you nothing about Walsall either, because I'm a stranger here too. But there's one thing I can tell you, and that's the way to heaven. You know, Bible gives us that, you see. When we're done, when we're finished on this earth, the Bible says it's not the end of the story, you know. It's not the finish, because the thing is that, you know, in 200 years' time, in a million years' time, you'll still be in existence. Your body be gone, buried, dead, you know. But your soul goes on, returns to God, and God disposes of it Well, as he pleases, as he wills. It's not the end, you see. Bible says, appointed for man once to die, and after this, then comes the judgment. Then we stand before God and we give account, you see, of all that we've done in the body, every careless word that we've ever spoken. Jesus says, we give account for. We're all of us, the Bible says, exposed to, naked and exposed to the eyes of Him to whom that we must give account. So friends, I want to, you know, point you in the right direction. I want to point you in the, you know, the way to heaven, as opposed, that is, you know, to the way to hell. You know, Bible makes it clear we're all of us travelers, you know. From the moment we are born, we are traveling, we are on a journey, we're heading towards eternity. It's inescapable. And here's the thing, but you know, what pathway are you on? Are you on the way to heaven, or are you on the way to perdition? Bible says the preaching of the gospel, the good news concerning God's Son, Jesus Christ, is foolishness to those who are perishing. If you see what I'm doing here today as foolishness, preaching the gospel to you, that's an evidence that you're on the pathway to perdition and you need to get off it. You see how? By repenting, change of mind, and by believing on the Lord Jesus Christ, and get on the way, get on the pathway to heaven. Jesus talks about, you know, about two ways, two roads. He says there's a narrow gate and there's a wide gate. The narrow gate leads on to a narrow pathway. The broad gate that leads on to a broad pathway. Two pathways, but the end of them are totally different. The broad one is popular. Thousands, millions travel down it. It's favored by most, but the end of it's eternal destruction, the end of it's hell. By going through the narrow, the straight gate that leads on to the narrow pathway, not so many travel that way. Only a few find it, only a few travel it, but the end of it is eternal life. The end of it is heaven. So I just want to tell you people today about the pathway, about the way that leads to heaven. That's the way that you need to take, and you need to be sure that you're on that pathway, that you're traveling in the right direction, that you know, that you understand, you know, whatever pathway you're on today, that you know what the end of it's going to be, you know. And the Bible, well, again, the Bible alone tells you, gives you that instruction. There's no other manual given to you by God. This is the Maker's instructions, you know. If your car ain't working properly, what's the first thing you do? You open the glove box and you take out the Maker's manual because you want to see, you know, how can I fix this? How can I get my car working properly, you know? And if you don't follow the Maker's instructions, you put the wrong spark plugs in, well, ain't no surprise if your car ain't working properly. You gotta follow the Maker's instructions in order to get the best out of your car. And friends, in order to get the best out of your life, and in order to get to heaven one day, you gotta follow the Maker's instructions, the Maker's manual, the Bible. Read to yourself and see that these things are so. We're all travelers. From the moment you're born, you're traveling, you're heading towards eternity, a lost eternity or eternity with God. You know, you're traveling, people, you're moving, you know, inescapably, you're moving towards eternity. You're moving towards that day. You start dying the moment you're born. And one day, of course, well, you'll breathe your last, you'll die physically. But that's not That's not the finish of death, the Bible says. You know, the wages of sin is death. People ask the question, no, why do men have to die? Well, because they're sinners, that's why. You know, some people argue and say, well, I ain't no sinner. Well, there's only one way you'll ever prove that, and that's by not dying. Everybody dies because everybody's sinners. All have sinned and come short of the glory of God, and so therefore we all die. The wages of sin is death, but the free gift of God is eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ, whom I proclaim to you here this afternoon. Ah, dear friends of Walsall, listen, you're traveling, you're moving inescapably towards that day when you will breathe your last, but that's not the finish of it. The Bible says the wages of sin is death, physical death, temporal death now, separated from God in this world, spiritual death. But then comes physical death, you breathe your last, but that's not the end, that's not the finish. Then comes the judgment of God. Then comes, friends, then comes what the Bible calls the second death, the lake of fire, the lake that burns with sulfur. Hell, hell's damnation, friends. For the unrepentant, for the unbelieving, for those who reject God's salvation. So you're a traveler, we're all fellow travelers, but our destinations are not all the same. It depends, friends, not on whether you're religious or not. Religion don't get you to heaven, that's not the way. That's not the pathway. Now, friends, you know, we're all traveling, you know, towards eternity, but your final destination, you know, it's down to this, what you do with God's Son, Jesus Christ. I don't come here to condemn you. I don't have to. Jesus says, I didn't come to condemn. I came to save. I came to rescue people. I came to save men, you know. Jesus didn't have to condemn people. I don't have to condemn you. You're already under the condemnation. Bible says, because you have not believed in God's only Son. He's the way to heaven. See, friends, your destination will be determined by what you do with God's Son, Jesus Christ. You reject Him, you reject heaven. But the way to heaven is through the Lord Jesus Christ. Listen up to what the Bible says. It tells you about the way to heaven. Thus says the Lord, stand by the roads and look, and ask for the old paths where the good way is, and walk in it and find rest for your souls. You see, friends, some people, they choose the wrong way. Oh, they want to get to heaven, but they choose the wrong way. They choose the watchtower society. They choose Islam, they choose Buddhism, they choose Confucianism, Rastafarianism, you know, all kinds of religious ideas, you know, are presented to you. And some people sincerely, genuinely, they want to get to heaven, and they choose those pathways, but they're the wrong ways. There's only one way, and that's the old, that's the ancient path. Some people, very religious, but I tell you, they're building their hopes for heaven on sinking sand. The solid rock of the gospel, God's Son, Jesus Christ, He's the rock. He's the rock, friends. He's the one, friends. If you build your life upon Him, you cannot fail. That is to get to heaven. But here's the thing, friends. You build your hopes on religious sand, you know. It's sinking ground, you know. Sink you down into the perdition of hell. Only one person can get you to heaven, and that's Jesus, Son of God, who loved sinners and gave Himself for them, who came to rescue us. Reception of Jesus, believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and you shall be saved. safe from the ravages of sin and go to heaven. But our friends, I tell you, there's many, many wrong roads. There's only one truth. There's only one God. There's no other God but Jesus Christ. He who speaks in the Bible, He alone is God. He's the true and living God who created the world you live in, who made you, who gave you life and breath, who governs this world, and who's the Savior of sinners. There is no other God. And friends, you know Him. You know Him just the same as I do. You might call yourself an atheist. You might call yourself an unbeliever, but you're not. You know that God is. He's made it plain to you. He says He's shown it to you. He says you even clearly understand that God is. Oh, you know that He is. But you suppress the truth in unrighteousness because you don't want there to be a God. Because you think that there being no God, you think that gives you freedom. You know, it feels like freedom. You think you can do as you please, but what does it do to you? What does it do to your body? What does it do to your health, your physical, your mental health? It destroys you in body. It destroys you in mind. And one day it will destroy your soul in the damnation of hell if you don't get saved. But God gave you His revelation, God gave you His word, the Bible, that you might be saved, that you might be delivered from such an end, that you might get to heaven. But here's the way to heaven. Stand by the road, says God, and look and ask for the old paths where the good way is, and walk in it and find rest for your souls. Ah, dear friends, the good way. The way that leads to heaven, friends. You know, the gospel, the good news concerning God's Son, Jesus Christ. It's about a person, friends, not about a religion, a person. His name is Jesus, and He's the Son of God, and He was proved to be the Son of God by the power of His resurrection from the dead. You deny that Jesus is God, you're on the pathway to hell. You're not on the way to heaven. You deny the reality and the truth of Jesus Christ, that He is God over all. Huh? You deny the truth about the person of Jesus Christ, that He's the Son of Man and the Son of God, that He's God manifest in the flesh. You are on your way to a lost eternity. You need to be saved. And only Jesus can save you. Only Jesus can rescue you. Only Jesus can give you hope and forgiveness and joy and peace, rest for your souls. Stand by the roads and look and ask for the old path where the good way is and walk in it. Find the good way and walk in it, says God. Well, you say, what is the way? It's the way of faith, friends. It's believing. Bible says that no flesh will ever be justified before God by their own works. You know, you can try to keep the law of God. You can try and keep the commandments of God. You failed all your days long up until now. And you will continue to fail to keep those commandments. You can't keep them because you've got a sinful nature. And you see, friends, that's why religion won't do it either. You can be very, very religious. You can do the five pillars of Mecca. You can do the seven stations of the cross. You can follow the writings of the Watchtower Society. That's all about doing. That's all about your doing. And there's nothing that you do can save you. There's nothing that you do, God says, can get you to heaven. It's only trusting in what somebody else has done that will get you to heaven. It's trusting in Jesus and what He did 2,000 years ago. What did He do? He died on a Roman cross. Oh, you say, thousands of guys died on Roman crosses. Sure they did. But only one who was the Son of God, only one who is an appointed Savior, Only one who is dying for the sins of others, for those who would believe in his name. The way, friends, is faith. It's not working, it's not being good, it's not being morally upright, it's not being religious. It's trusting in what Jesus has done and dying on the cross for a sinner such as you and I. Jesus did it all. He cried from the cross in triumph. It is finished. He did it all. He died for sinners. So that when you put your trust, your faith in him, that you're saved and you've got the guarantee, you've got God's assurance that you're bound for heaven. You're on the way to hell, to heaven instead of hell. You see, friends, the good way that you walk in, that God wants you to walk in, it's the ancient pathway. It was always by faith. Way back to the beginning of the Bible, the days of Abraham, before the Watchtower Society was ever born, before Mecca was ever built, before the Quran was ever invented, before Buddha was ever a twinkle in his mother's eye. Way, way back to the beginning, when your first parents, Adam and Eve, sinned, God issued the promise that the person who believed in Jesus would be saved. It's always been faith. That's the old path. That's the ancient path that God would have you to walk in. The faith of Abraham. Abraham saw my day, Jesus says, and he was glad. He was glad. Why? Because he saw the one who would die on the cross and rise again from the dead and justify him before Almighty God. Faith in Jesus, friends, that's the way to heaven. That's the old path. That's the good way. That's the way that God would have you to walk in, and your destination will be heaven. Oh, it will be. God promises heaven to all who believe in Jesus. It's the way of repentance, friends. First word of the gospel, first words of Jesus recorded in the New Testament, repent and believe the gospel. Repentance means a change of mind. Change of mind about your sin. A change of mind about your involvement in sin. Change of mind, you know, thinking, a change of your mindset. Let the wicked forsake his way and the unrighteous man his thoughts. In repentant, friends, you read the Bible, you believe the Bible, and you begin to think the way that God thinks, you know. You align your mind with God's mind, you know, and your life begins to change. Your heart's transformed, you see, from the inside out. You let go, you know, of the thinking of the world, evolutionary nonsense. You let go of your religious activities and you put your trust in the one who can be trusted. It's a change of mind, friends, about God, about his being, about his character, his holiness, about his righteous demands of you. It's a change of mind, friends, about Jesus. Who and what he is and what he can do for you. It's a change of mind, friends. It's a change of mind. Repent, 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 and believe the gospel. The way to heaven, friends, the good way that God would have you to walk in is the way of repentance and faith towards his Son, Jesus Christ. That's the way to heaven. It's the way, friends, of confessing the Lord Jesus Christ before men. If a man or woman truly believes in Jesus, trusts in Jesus, they'll confess his name unashamedly, not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ. Why? Because it's the power of God for salvation, friends. You believe in Jesus, sir? Huh? You saved, you're born again? How'd that come? Huh? How'd that come about? Okay. Huh? You've been born again?
No,
you follow Jesus? You don't understand? No, okay. Now they're going to say, friends, you got to be born again, you know. The people, you see, they confess the name of Jesus. They say, yeah, yeah, you know. You know, but friends, here's the thing. Do you confess his name before others? Not ashamed. You know, one of the authors of the Bible, he says, I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ. Why? He says, because it's the power of God unto salvation. You know, what's to be ashamed of Jesus for? He's your creator. You stand on his earth, you breathe his air, you eat his food, you know? Hey, you stand under his sky. What's to be ashamed of Jesus for? But if you've repented of your sin, if you've believed on the Lord Jesus Christ, the way you walk is in confessing him before man, confessing that you belong to him, that he owns you, telling others about the way to heaven, the way that they can be saved, the way that they can be right with God. You don't hide the light under the bushel, you know? Jesus, he's the light of the world. And if you're saved, if you belong to him, you want the whole world to know that Jesus is alive from the dead, that Jesus ever lives, and that Jesus saves, and that Jesus is able to save you here this afternoon if you will but repent and believe the gospel. Stand by the roads and look and ask for the ancient paths where the good way is, and walk in it and find rest for your souls. The way to heaven, friends, is the way of obedience to Jesus Christ. Doing what he tells you to do. Jesus says, follow me. Following Jesus, well, you follow his word, you follow. If you love him, you do what he tells you to do. And you do it gladly, you do it willingly. You do it because you love him, not just out of a sense of duty. That's the difference, you see, between religious people and those who have been born again. You know, those whose hearts have been changed, those who have been made alive in Jesus. You know, they do what they do, and they do what Jesus tells them to do, not just out of a sense of duty, not because they got to do it. They do it because they're saved. They do it because they know they're going to heaven. They do it because he has loved them and died for them and rose again from the dead for them. They do it because they love him, you know, out of obedience, a loving heart of obedience. That's what God requires of you. That's the way, that's the good way, and that's the way that God would have you to walk in. But friends, it's the old way. It's the old way. This ain't no new religion. This is the old story of Jesus and his love. It was declared 2,000 years ago. It was declared way before that. Even before he died on the cross, it was being declared amongst men and women. It was declared before Buddha was born. It was declared before Muhammad was born. It was declared the good news, the ancient paths. It goes right back to the beginning, friends. Way back even before Abraham was born. The good news of the gospel. How that Jesus, the seed of the woman, would come into the world to save sinners. And that's the path. That's the ancient path. That's the old path that God would have you to take to walk in order that you might be saved and that you might get to heaven. Ain't no other way, friends. Ain't no other way to heaven. Only through Jesus, faith in his name, trusting in what he has done, repenting of your sin, changing your mind about God, about your sin, and about Jesus. Ah, friends, the way to heaven. You're all traveling, all on a journey, all heading towards eternity. But what will your final destination be? Well, it will be determined by what you do with Jesus, what you do with the Son of God. Believe on his name, and you shall be saved. It's the good way, says God. The old paths, you know? The way of repentance and faith towards Jesus. It's the old path. It's the trusted, tried pathway. It leads to heaven every time. It's the good way. It's the good way, says God. It's good spiritually because it gets you right with God. It gets you on the right side of God. It gets you on the smiley side of God instead of the angry side of God. Because here's the thing, friends. The wrath of God is already being revealed from heaven against all the ungodliness and unrighteousness of men. You're spiritually wrong. God's angry with you. He's angry with the wicked every day. Oh, but the good way, the way of faith towards Jesus, that's the good way, good spiritually, because it gets you on the good side of God. It gets you on the right side of God. It gets you on the smiley side of God. It gets you on the loving side of God. And oh, friends, it's the good way. It's the good way because it's good. It changes a person morally, you know? You got a world full of religion, hey, but it goes about the world killing people. I mean, what use is that to anybody? We can do that without religion. But hey, the gospel, the good news about Jesus changes a man or woman morally. It puts moral principles into their souls. And they do the good. They don't go about killing. They don't go about stealing. They don't go about fornicating. They don't go about sodomizing. They don't go about doing the filth and uncleanness. They don't go about doing the abortion. Because the gospel, the good news about Jesus, the ancient pathway, the good way that God would have you to walk in, it changes a person morally. It makes them good morally. But ain't that the reason why you don't want the gospel? Isn't that the reason why you don't want the gospel? Ah, you'll have your religion because you can do your religion and do your fornicating. Yeah? You can do your religion and you can do your killing. You know? You can do your secularism. You can do your evolutionary lie. You can live the lie. Love the lie. It feels like freedom. I can do what I want. But the end of it, friends, is hell's damnation, not heaven. It's the good way that you need. And you need to walk in it. In the way of repentance and faith towards Jesus, the Son of God. That's the way to heaven. That's the only way to heaven. And so the course for you to take is to make serious inquiry of Jesus. And I mean serious. Ask, he says, and it shall be given. Seek and ye shall find. Knock and the door shall be opened unto you. To seek him diligently that you might find him. Seek ye the Lord while he may be found. Won't always be to be found. Hurry, 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 friends. Like your very soul depended upon it, and it does. You know? Friends, in a mighty hurry, because hey, this might be your last day on planet Earth, who knows? Maybe I'm talking to somebody here in Walsall this afternoon, and this is the last time you'll ever hear the good news of the gospel. It's the last time you'll ever hear the overtures of God's love. Maybe this is your last day on planet Earth, friends. Hurry, hurry, hurry to Jesus. The matter is urgent, serious inquiry. On your knees before Almighty God and cry out to him. Get yourself home and shut the door. Nail it shut if you have to. And get on your knees and cry out to him. And don't get off them until he comes to you, until you know that you're forgiven, until you know that you're on the way to heaven. Ah, friends, serious inquiry at God's throne of grace must be made by you. No easy thing, I tell you, to get out of your sinful nature. That nature in which you were born, that nature in which you've lived until this time, take a miracle, friends. No easy thing. You don't just step away from it, you know, like it was nothing. You got to get out of that vile nature in which you were born. You got to get that deceitful heart out of you. You got to get changed by the almighty power of King Jesus. Only a miracle can do it. You must be born again. Except a man is born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. Oh, dear friends, make serious inquiry of Jesus. Get out of your sin nature and get into the kingdom of God. Get born again. Get repented. Get believing. That's the way to heaven. That's the old paths. That's the good way. That's the way that God would have you to walk in. But friends, you got to make the choice. What's it going to be, heaven or hell? What's it going to be, a life of sin or a life of godliness? What's it going to be, friends? You got to make the choice, you know? Jesus, you know, he's the only one who can get you there. You know, Bible talks, Jesus talks about some people taking the kingdom of God by violence, you know, not taking no for an answer, storming the throne of God and crying out to him and demanding of him salvation in the name of Jesus. Whoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved, calling and calling and calling until he comes to you, until he saves you. Until you know that you're born again. Until you know that you're going to heaven. Friends, taking the kingdom of heaven by violence. Taking no for an answer. Day by day, moment by moment. Giving him no rest until he comes to you. Until you know that you've been saved. Until you know that you're right with God. And the promise is, friends, the promise is rest for your souls from the guilty fears that haunt you. Your religion doesn't take those away. You still got the guilt, you still got the fear because you're still in your sin. Because religion doesn't remove that, only the blood of God's Son does that. The ancient paths, it's always been the same. The old paths, the prophet Moses declared in the law, he said, without the shedding of blood, there can be no forgiveness of sins. If you're religious, you're still in your sin, friends. God himself provided the blood sacrifice, his own son, the Lamb of God, who takes away the sin of the world. Oh, dear friends, it's Jesus you need. It's God's Lamb that you need. It's the blood sacrifice of Calvary that you need. That alone can take away all the guilt and all the fear associated with it. The ancient pathway, the good way, walk in it, friends. Walk in it. Rest for your soul. Rest from the guilt and the fear and the damage that sin does to your mind and to your soul. Rest from the slavery of sin. Ah, you say, I'm free. I'm a free man. I'm a free woman. You say, I can do as I please. Can you really? Can you? Then walk away from your sin. Walk away from your addiction. Why do you go to the chemist for patches if you're free? Walk away from the fags. Walk away from the drugs. Walk away from the immorality. Walk away from the depression. Walk away from the slander. Walk away if you're a free man, a free woman. Walk away from it. But you're not free at all. You're not free at all. You can't be free outside Jesus. You're a slave to your sin. You're a slave to your sin. Some of you, you're slaves to idolatrous religion, but you're slaves to a man, to a woman, without Jesus. If the Son shall make you free, you shall be free indeed. Only Jesus can liberate you from the power of sin. That's what he died for. That's why he died on the cross, to set people, men and women, free from their slavery, to deliver them from their bondage, to set them free to worship God and one day go to heaven. But that's the way to heaven, friends. Rest for your souls. One day, eternal rest when you breathe your last and you go out of this world. You cock your toes up and you go out the world just like everybody else. But instead of going to hell, instead of being damned for all eternity, God welcomes you into heaven in his Son, Jesus Christ. But without him, friends, without Jesus, death will rush you into the presence of a holy and sin-hating God who will rush you into the damnation of hell. If you're not saved, if you have not repented and believed the gospel, if you have not trusted in God's Son, Jesus Christ, that's the way to heaven. That's the ancient path. That's the good way. That's the way that God would have you to walk in. Repenting of your sin, trusting in Jesus, trusting in what he did. That's the pathway to heaven. That's the pathway to eternal glory. Which will it be, friends? The broad road or the narrow road? Heaven or hell hangs upon what I declare amongst you today. Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ. You shall be saved. God's command with the promise. Whoever calls upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. First word of the gospel, repent, says Jesus. Repent and believe the gospel. Why? Because the kingdom of God is at hand. Repent ye and believe the gospel. Repent ye and believe the gospel. Repent ye and believe the gospel. For the kingdom of God is at hand. As you'd like to have a copy of God's word, read for yourself and see that these things are so. Copy of the New Testament is offered to you, free of charge, no cost, no obligation to you. Yours take and do with as you will. You'd like a one, you come and ask for it. May God bless you abundantly, and bring you into the ancient path, the good way, to walk in it, the pathway to heaven. May God have mercy upon your precious, precious souls.